Clint says, you talked about cushions controlling output over your bench bell. Have you ever tried that on the glass cooktop to send all the heat to your bench? Great question, Clint. I've had a few customers ask me about exactly that. And we talked last week about the, well, as a matter of fact, you were the one who brought it up, your lovely Aga that you had at your old home. The Agas do have that feature. They have that cooktop lid that comes down over the cooktop. And I'm going to say this, Clint. I think it's a wonderful idea. It works excellently. I had a customer in London do that on their stove. They were building, much like you, they were building a water heater cooktop combination. They wanted to push as much heat downstream, so they covered the cooktop. However, the one thing I don't know, Clint, is if it will work with the glass top. So I have a theory. The glass tops are rated at about 1300 degrees Fahrenheit, continuous use. I know they can take hotter, but I'm pretty sure that they're holding up to the abuse that we give them because they have the ability to shed that heat out the other side. They radiate it so quickly that the actual material can stabilize itself at a temperature that it can stand. I've often wondered, because I've had people say, well, what can we do, double windows, you know, to keep the heat from coming into the room? They just want to look at it, don't want to feel it. And I've said this too, and I've often wondered if once you cover that glass up, if you're dooming it to failure. And I don't know the answer to that, Clint, and I apologize to say that I can't give you a definitive answer. What I can say is that, you know, if that's a really important feature for you, you may consider changing from the ceramic glass to a cast iron cooktop. There's a whole host of wonderful cast iron pieces you can get for cooktops. You can either buy griddles, you know, and just fit them into your stove. They come in various sizes. I think Lodge makes one that's a pretty darn big one. You can buy old flat tops from commercial kitchens. That whole top piece of a commercial flat top is just a cast iron griddle. So that's an easy piece to retrofit to a wood cook stove build. And lastly, there are pieces made by Piesla and other masonry heater hardware builders. They offer cast iron cooktops, usually with like rails and things already attached to them, and they're meant to be installed on a heater that you build custom for that cooktop. And our friend Sue at Northstone Heat could help you source some of those if you'd like to look into those choices. So to reiterate, I think covering the cooktop to push heat downstream is an awesome idea and a great way to go. Whether or not the ceramic glass can take it, I don't know. I don't even, like, if you ask me to predict whether it can take it, I'd just flip a coin. I really am unsure. It seems to me it's right at the cusp of what it can take. I would be not surprised to find out that it was fine, and I would be not surprised to find out that it broke every time it got covered in insulation. I just don't know. So I hope that answers your question, Clint. I definitely think it's an awesome idea, and I think the AGA implementation of that idea was gorgeous. I would love to see something like that. I do have a picture of the stove in England. I'll share it with us on next Stove Chat. It's really nice looking, and I think that it did a nice job for them pushing more heat down to the water heat exchange area.